In a previous demo, I showed you the basics of just step one of learning to learn about set-based programming and set-based programming techniques. And this was using an array just to insert some data versus using a set of independent Java threads all loading one row at a time. And these were experiencing contention within the index, or they were all contending because they were all committing at the same time. But let's take this idea of set-based programming a little bit further and start thinking about what we do with large data sets. And we're going to break it down into four blocks. We're going to think about loading data, because we all have the requirements to ingest or load or insert a large amount of data into the database at speed. How will we best do that? Then we're going to start thinking about validating data. We get data from all disparate data sources. How do we validate that it's good data? It's unique keys are unique, foreign keys are foreign keys, and orphan rows and things like that. So we have a means of validating to see that the data is correct from an integrity point of view. The next level is we're likely to want to transform and modify data because it probably isn't perfect, or it came from lots of disparate systems that may have anomalies in the data, like the tax code, the dates, formatting, the time zones appropriate, different calendar systems, and things like that. And then we will look to aggregate data potentially for pushing on to smaller data mart systems, or just to provide easier querying on the data warehouse for modelers who are quite happy working with aggregates. So we can see that we've got this sort of pipeline of data disciplines that we have to learn how to do with large data sets. And what we're going to do is show through, and we're going to pop up some code snippets and some ways to show how to do it. But we're going to follow the same techniques as we showed in the previous demo, is that we're going to start racing these different programming techniques against each other. They've all got the same amount of hardware, they've all got the same data, but some just take longer than others, and it's all in the programming techniques that are adopted. Some of the techniques will only ever use a single CPU, some of them will use multiple, some will use multiple CPUs more efficiently than others. And these are the things we need to learn as we move forward in this game. Of those disciplines we described, let's look at the first one, which is loading. And to load the data, we're going to use four different techniques, and we're going to see those techniques over and over again. We're going to use a mixture of row-by-row processing. We're going to use array techniques, as we showed earlier. And then we're going to call what we call homegrown parallelism. And I'm sure you've all seen that in somebody who's got a job that's taken too long and they've chopped the job in half by doing two different sets of data or something arbitrary like even numbers and odd numbers or months of the year. And they've segmented data up and they've basically taken their serial programs and running multiple copies on it on different sets of data. And then the last one is going to be true set-based processing, where we're able to exploit core parallelism within the database to achieve both parallelism and get the work done. And so you can bake off and see which is probably going to be the best technique for you. So in terms of data loading, let's start a race of data loading using the four different techniques. I'm going to start the thing, and you'll notice very quickly the set-based techniques are pulling way ahead of the other techniques. And as you can see, the red bar shooting across the side. And we're going to leave loading, I think it's about 101 million rows in this case. And each of the techniques is using an individual node in a half rack of Exadata. So they've all got the same amount of hardware. They've all got one node. But let's look at the difference in the performance. Now, the winner was racer number four, which was the set-based technique, and he took 22 seconds. The homegrown parallelism technique, they took a minute and a half. The array interface technique, which was the first method we showed earlier, took nearly 15 minutes. And if you'd done it as a row-by-row program, it would have taken 3 hours, 43 minutes, and 5 seconds. Again, we're demonstrating the difference in coding techniques can make literally orders of magnitude difference to the performance. And to get things down from hours to seconds is always interesting, because when things come down from hours to seconds, that means you're 1,000 times faster. And that is a great objective to have if you're doing real world performance. If you make your target 1,000 times faster, you actually start to change the game. You make the business different. Imagine jobs you are running in the middle of the night that are taking hours to run. If you get those jobs from hours to seconds, you're more likely to run them in real time, in phase with the business. You're able to make decisions in real time. And basically, you bring performance engineering is bringing an edge to your business. Instead of having performance as something that is a problem, it's something you can be proactive on and make the game a better game. So that was loading. Well, let's talk a little bit about the code techniques that were used to load all this data. Well, it's pretty simple in this time. And we've coded things up in PL/SQL, but don't let the language distract you. The fact that we did it in PL/SQL just made our lives easier. But you can make all the same performance enhancements if your coding mechanism is via Java, C++, C, even COBOL, if you're still writing COBOL programs. The language doesn't matter. It's the algorithms and the techniques you adopt is the important part of the game. So let's have a look at the row-by-row code. And as you can see, it's a very simple PL/SQL program, basically a cursor loop that's going into a fetch state, and it's taking, for every row that you fetch, it's inserting into a table. Pretty simple concept. If I had a dollar for every time I saw programs like this in the real world, I would be having a very high performance car in my garage. So anyway, that's the way it goes. This is very simple. Now, if we take it up to the array process, you won't be surprised to see much more on that, but we're gonna see the similar sort of code construct. But the programmer in this case has used the PL/SQL bulk operators to effect an array insert. And that worked well, but remember, you can only use a single core. It was a lot faster than when if you did it row by row. We were talking 3¾ hours down to 1/4 hour. So that's a big gain, and you're just using the same one CPU. But if you're looking to get this data, 1 million rows of data loaded in seconds, we need to start taking up some parallel techniques. Now, the homegrown parallelism runs a pretty much the same program, but what we've actually made the homegrown programmer has actually decided to start cutting up the data and handing off the work. So in fact, what we're doing is we're scanning the source data multiple times, and we're using the Aura hash function to figure out how to divide the data between all the parallel inserting slaves. And by this mechanism, we're getting some manual parallelism and manual division of data between query slaves. And so we run 32 of those jobs, all hashing by 32 on Aura hash, such that each slave loads a 32nd of the data. But again, you can see we fundamentally are running the same algorithm as we ran in the serial program, but we're starting to take advantage of chopping the data up, parallelism, and the array interface, the bulk operators. But if we actually come down and actually look, and you'll notice that with all these elaborate techniques, the code seems to be getting more complicated and more confusing. So let's look at the set-based programming code. Well, that was a bit of a surprise, because we got a lot less code there than all the other ones put together. Basically, a simple insert with an append hint, the result of the query from the external table, scan events table. This is the least amount of code, yet it is also the fastest. Now, the reasons why it's fast is it's basically able to take advantage of core Oracle parallelism to do the insert. Is also taking advantage of the append hint. And an append hint is a pure set-based technique because it allows us to do bulk data loading, but it can also be done in a fast path, such we're avoiding generation of undo and redo. So we're cutting down the amount of CPU we're burning, we're cutting out the amount of IO we're doing, and it becomes an extremely fast way of loading a large amount of data. So much, in fact, that basically a program that was running in 3¾ hours is now running in 22 seconds. And this is just taking advantage of core Oracle database set-based techniques and technology that run in parallel and has been designed to handle large amounts of data.